You rarely go to a sporting event or participate in an outdoor concert without seeing a tailgate party in the parking lot. People open up the back of their pickup truck, their Jeep, their SUV, and they use the tailgate as a table. So they spread out the food, they get out the beverages, and they party till the food's gone, or the event starts or ends, as the case may be. But after the tailgate party's over, people don't drive down the freeway with the tailgate open and the food spread out. At worst, they'll cause a wreck. At best, they'll likely get a ticket for reckless driving. The truck, the RV, the Jeep, the SUV has two different purposes, either a picnic or transportation. Likewise, PowerPoint is a tool. Presenters can use it to create slides to support a presentation, or they can use it to create a document. Never confuse the two. When discussing principles of slide design in our presentation skills training programs, participants often make comments like these. Well, in our organization, we use PowerPoint just to write. Then we make copies of the slide deck for everyone in the meeting, and we just discuss the issues. Or maybe a salesperson says something like this, "Well, the slide deck is my sales proposal." Or someone says, "My boss wants to have a copy of the slides to review later and think through all the issues to make a decision. She wants complete information on all those key points." Or somebody says, "Well, I go to a meeting just to answer questions. The slide deck itself is the real presentation. We send it ahead and everyone's already read it before they get to the meeting." Well, now, if you choose to use PowerPoint rather than the Microsoft Word tool for writing documents, fine. You can choose to write it in all bullet points with small font. You can put 12 or 15 lines on a slide page. But understand that the outcome is a document, not a presentation slide. That document created with the PowerPoint tool works fine as a handout for a sit-down meeting, which everyone will have a reference copy. As long as you know how to use it well, and as long as it doesn't compete with you for the group's attention. You can use that same PowerPoint tool to create a presentation slide. But for that purpose, keep in mind that slide after slide after slide of bullet points produces boredom, and it kills engagement. My point is that what makes a great presentation visual makes a lousy handout, and what makes a great handout makes a lousy presentation slide. One tool, two different design principles, two different sets of principles. Never confuse the two purposes or the end result.